In this video, I want to share my personal experience with tutorial hell while setting up Neovim and how I escaped from it. I wanted to switch to Neovim, a highly extensible keyboard-based editor, to see if I could replace WebStorm as my main IDE. So I decided to watch a few tutorials on how to get started with NvChad, a Neovim framework for quick setup. Everything was going pretty well. I was able to set up this nice looking IDE that resembled IDEs like WebStorm and VS Code. However, things took a turn when I was following the setup for LSP, a language server protocol that enables code completion, error checking, etc. The tutorial I was following was setting it up for Rust while I needed TypeScript. I attempted to follow the documentation listed in the LSP server configuration, but I struggled to put it all together. I was stuck with this error that I just couldn't figure out. And the worst part is, I don't even know where to begin to debug this issue at all. Then it all clicked. Watching these tutorials gives me comfort and this illusion that I was making progress because I'm seeing these fancy results. But the truth is that I still don't understand how any of this works under the hood. I don't have the foundational knowledge of any of these core components that make up the NvChad configuration. If I want to really understand how NvChad works, I need to start from the bottom up and truly understand how these core components work. I need to break my problem down into smaller parts and start from there. After tons of research, the core components that make up the Neovim experience are Lua, the scripting language for managing the configuration, a package manager like Packer that is used for installation and management of plugins and extensions for Neovim, a fuzzy finder that provides quick and efficient searching and navigation within the project, and of course the tree sitter, which enables advanced syntax highlighting, making code visually appealing and easy to read. Finally, the LSP for code completion, error checking, etc. By starting from the foundational knowledge and learning how these core components work, I've gained a deeper understanding of the underlying concepts and principles. I won't lie, this attempt was super slow, frustrating, and I really just wanted to quit and go back to WebStorm so many times. But I'm glad I stuck with it because now I can say that I really do understand these essential components that make up the NvChad default configuration. I even understand how IDEs like VS Code and WebStorm work behind the scene now. There is often a lot of emphasis on learning fast, acquiring skills to land a job in a few months, or becoming a full stack developer in 12 weeks and so on. And I think that's why we watch a tutorial and have this expectation that we'll become a seasoned professional. I think it's fine to watch tutorials to get started, but we need to dig deeper, expand our knowledge, and use it to build your own projects without any help. We need to struggle and find our own solutions, and through these struggles is where we say goodbye to tutorial hell. If you found this video helpful, please consider giving it a thumbs up and subscribing to my channel for more tech-related content. I'd love to hear about your experiences with tutorial hell in the comment below. Thank you for watching. This is David signing off. I'll see you in the next one.